Good morning, Lincoln Lions. This is Mr. Conan. This is your daily announcements for Monday, April 20th, 2020. That's a lot of 20s, like 20, 20, 20. Anyway, please stand for the pledge. 3, 2, 1. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Next, let's hop right into our Lincoln spirit on 3, 1, 2, 3. Lincoln spirit makes us proud, respectful lions above the crowd. Our spirit makes us try our best and challenges us to encourage the rest. All right, today we're going to skip around a little bit. We have two things we're going to do today. One, we have a brand new principal coming to Lincoln. Yes, I'm leaving. I'm sad. I'm sure I'll have more messages for you, but I want to keep this message happy because they just hired a brand new principal for Lincoln Elementary. His name is Ty Moore. He's actually a friend of mine, and I'm so happy to be able to get him ready to go to take over Lincoln. I think he's going to be fantastic. Kids are going to love him. Parents are going to love him. Community is going to love him. In fact, let's learn a little bit more about him. Are you ready? Yeah, we're going to do an interview with him, with Mr. Moore. Here is the interview. All right, this next section this morning, we are going to actually meet your new principal here at Lincoln Elementary. I have a great friend I'd like to introduce you to. He's coming to us right now. He is the acting administrator at Sunnyside Elementary until the remainder of the year. But lucky I'm going to be able to work with him the rest of the year to get him ready to transition into this job. So I'd like to have Mr. Ty Moore come on over, Mr. Moore.
Good morning.
Tell us a little bit about you, Mr. Moore.
So, like Mr. Coyne said, I came from Sunnyside. I've been a teacher over there for the last 7 years. I'm married to my wonderful wife, Sasha. She's currently at Valley View right now. I have two wonderful kids, 7 and 10, and they're attending Meadow Lark Elementary. And we're excited to have a new adventure, and I can't wait to get started.
Well, we'd like to make sure you upset at least half of the people right away by asking, are you Bobcat or are you Grizz, or do you have ties to both?
No, I'm Bobcat 100%. There's no halfway. I will say that I root for that other school when we're not playing them. So I'll give them that. That's a 1%.
Okay, well, we've really converted a lot of people over, Mr. Moore, over to the Bobcats, but you are going to get a lot of people that are trying to force you to do some more Grizz stuff. In the Cat Grizz Food Challenge that we've had every single year, Bobcats have won every single year. Maybe once they didn't win, but since I've been here, we've been doing that for 9. So what I bring up are some of these things that we know that we like to do at Lincoln. There's some of our culture pieces that have been traditions that have been going on for a long time. And so what we're asking of you guys is to maybe talk about a little bit of that with Mr. Moore and share on this video, on this post, to tell Mr. Moore what are some of the things that you like about Lincoln that we've had long traditions that are ongoing. Of course, whenever you get a new principal in, they may have some new traditions as well. And so what I know about Mr. Moore, though, is that he loves kids. I've watched him work with kids. I've been in his school several times when he's done that. And I think that's probably the number one thing why I think Mr. Moore is ready for this job. And I think he's going to do a fantastic job here at Lincoln and connecting with you. So let's go a little bit deeper, Mr. Moore. What are some things that you like to do for fun outside of school?
Oh, I love to golf. I love to fish. I like to ski in the wintertime. So we are outside all the time. I have a bachelor's degree in landscape design, so we like to garden. That's our therapy at home. We play in our yard. We live out of town, so we have a nice quiet area that we can just play in landscape, and my kids like to do it as well. So we're big into renovating things. We're flipping over an old camper that's in a 63 Airstream, so we like to kind of flip things around and and make things new. So
fantastic. Keeps us busy. All right. Another question that I have for you is, right now with having school closure going on, what are some ideas you think would be great for kids to know about at home right now? So I'm going to have you act like you're a principal. What are some things that maybe kids could be doing at home right now to make sure that they're being successful?
Well, I think number one is schedule. Keep up a good schedule. Keep something that works for you guys as kids. Help out your parents. You're going to learn a lot from your parents just by helping them out. When you get to the academics part of it, really try and work on it with the intent of learning one thing new every day. Try and take away from whatever it is that you're focusing on. Just take one thing and build on that one thing. And then get outside. I mean, we're lucky enough right now, we're in a state, we're in the time of the year that we can get outside, and we can do that learning outside. There's a lot of things that are getting posted online that we can do, but at the same time, go outside and do some writing and reading outside. Get out.
That is great. That's great advice for all of us too. So we've talked about for kids. What's one thing maybe you want to talk to Lincoln parents about you coming into this position or anything like that?
One of the things for parents, communication. Like, talk to us. What do you need help? Where do you need help at? You're not teachers, you're parents, and that's your number one job. We are here to support you as the parent. Let us know what we can do. Parents, get that schedule going. Don't freak out. Stay calm. Let us help you. Call us, email us, let us know where we can help you. And remember, you're at home with your kids. That's your number one priority. Family first, kids first. Keep it that way. Nothing's changed. Always keep that kids and the family first in the front of your mind of what's best for you. It's not necessarily going to be what's best for everybody else. It's going to be what's best for you, and you have to make it work for you.
Excellent. Thanks, Ty. That's some great information. I know that Lincoln is really strong with school culture, but we're also really strong with our school family. We have great parents. We have a really strong PTA that helps support us here. And we love being able to work with our PTA and get them into our school. We have several great big events that we do every single year. We have a great PTA president. It's also our secretary right now. And that'll be transitioning as well. So there'll be some other transitions going forward here. So what I'm asking of you now is to think of some questions that you'd like to ask Mr. Moore. And then we'll start posting some of those questions all throughout the rest of the remainder of the year when Mr. Moore gets time. Just remember, Mr. Moore is still the acting principal at Sunnyside. So he's going to continue to do that for the remainder of the year. But let's get some questions to him in his spare time. Hopefully, he'll be able to answer some of your questions, either from parents or from students, about this upcoming year. Because we would like to communicate as much as possible so you get to know Mr. Moore way before he even sets foot with kids here at school. So any last words, Mr. Moore?
No, I'm excited. I am super excited to be here. I can't wait to hear all the ideas and hear all the questions. I learn the most from questions, so fire them off. I love answering questions, and I love parent communication and parent contact. It's one of my favorite parts of my day, and I love the conferences. I love the conversations that come from it. So don't be shy. There's no such thing as a silly question. Ask away.
Fantastic. I'm excited. You can tell he's excited too. So again, post questions either on this Facebook post or send them to your teacher or email them to me, and I will get them to Mr. Moore so we can probably make another video to be able to give you some answers back. So with that, no further ado, then we're heading on to our book of the day. Thank you.
And as you heard me say, we are going to actually head on to that book of the day. And it is today by Iris Moore. Iris Moore has chosen one of Pete the Cat books. And so I think you're going to love her being able to read this story to you. So at the very end of it, we'll have some questions for you. Make sure you're listening so you can answer the questions we come up with.
Hi, my name is Iris, and I will be reading Pete the Cat, Too Cool for School by Kimberly and Jason B. Pete wants to look cool. He asks everyone, "What should I wear?" "Wear your yellow shirt," his mom says. It is my favorite. So Pete does. Wear your red shirt, Pete's friend Marty says. It is my favorite. So Pete does. Wear your blue shirt, Pete's brother Bob says. It is my favorite. So Pete does. Wear your long pants, Pete's teacher says. They are my favorite. So Pete does. Wear the shorts with the fish, Pete's friend Callie says. They are my favorite. So Pete does. Wear the polka dot socks, the bus driver says. They are my favorite. So Pete does. Wear the cowboy boots, Grumpy Toad says. They are my favorite. So Pete does. Wear the tie with the stripes, Emma says. It is my favorite. So Pete does. Wear your baseball hat, his coach says. It is my favorite. So Pete does. Pete puts on all the clothes. Does he look cool? No, Pete looks silly. He also feels very odd. Pete goes home. He changes his clothes. Pete puts on his favorite shirt. Pete puts on his favorite pants. Pete puts on his favorite socks. Pete puts on his favorite shoes. And Pete puts on his glasses. Pete says, "Now I am cool." If you want to be cool, just be you. So, tomorrow, wear your favorite outfit that you like to wear and be cool. Send a picture of you wearing your outfit to our Lincoln Facebook page. Thank you. Miss you guys.
What a great message from Miss Iris Moore. Yes, she did a great job reading Pete the Cat book. So she had a challenge for you, and that challenge was to wear what you want to wear tomorrow and then post it for us. Either send it to your teacher or post it up on the Facebook page. That would be fantastic. So today, Mr. Conan gets to pick the song that we are going to do today. And so it's all about his shoes. Have you noticed Mr. Conan's shoes? He's got several different types of shoes, and we're going to play a song called Pumped Up Kicks, because guess what? When you're at home right now, you can choose to wear anything you want on your feet, and Mr. Conan continues to change shoes at least two or three times a day. So here we go, Pumped Up Kicks. Go be a positive warrior and go Lion Pride.